I'm Catherine Lhamon, Assistant Secretary for Civil Rights at the U.S. Department of Education. Returning to school brings about many emotions for students across the United States. But returning or going to school should never make students feel fearful, unwelcome, or excluded. Although public schools should be safe learning environments for all students, some students face discrimination because of their race, color, or national origin. These forms of discrimination limit students' access to education and are against the law. We are here to help.
I'm Kristen Clarke, Assistant Attorney General for the Civil Rights Division of the U.S. Department of Justice, and we appreciate school administrators and educators who are working hard to ensure that all students feel welcome at school. We also want everyone to know that the federal government is committed to protecting the rights of all students to attend schools free from discrimination. Under our nation's federal civil rights laws, our offices investigate and address racially discriminatory school discipline, discriminatory student enrollment policies, racial harassment and bullying, barriers faced by English learners, and more.
For example, in summer 2022, the Department of Education's Office for Civil Rights reached an agreement that requires a school district in California to address racially discriminatory discipline policies. OCR determined that the district violated federal law by disciplining Black students more frequently and more harshly than similarly situated white students. We look forward to the corrective actions the district has committed to implementing on behalf of all students. In fall 2022, OCR entered into a resolution agreement with a school district in Arizona to address district-wide racial harassment and a hostile environment for students. OCR found that the district did not address harassment that included the use of racial slurs, targeted mocking of racially sensitive issues, and the display of racially hostile and anti-Semitic symbols and gestures. The district has committed to providing appropriate supports and remedies for students, in addition to making policy changes to address the school's climate and instituting annual staff training.
The Department of Justice also protects the civil rights of students of color in this country, including protection from national origin discrimination. For example, the Civil Rights Division secured a settlement with a school district in Massachusetts to protect English learner students who are from indigenous Maya communities. The agreement requires reforms so that the district will better recognize and meet the unique needs of these students and their families. The division also secured a settlement with a school district in Utah to remedy severe racial harassment faced by Black and Asian American students. For years, students endured unchecked harassment in school, including racial slurs, taunts, and assaults. Under the agreement, the district is making major reforms to address the racially hostile environment and discrimination when it comes to school discipline. When public schools discriminate on the basis of race, color, or national origin, our agencies can help by enforcing federal laws that protect students from discrimination. And we want to hear from you. You can file a complaint with the Justice Department at civilrights.justice.gov. The information is available in multiple languages. Discrimination will not be accepted on our watch.
If you or someone you know experiences discrimination on the basis of race, color, or national origin, including discrimination based on actual or perceived shared ancestry or ethnic characteristics, you can file a complaint with OCR at ocrcas.ed.gov. For language assistance when contacting OCR, call 1-800-USA-LEARN. That's 1-800-872-5327. Or email OCR at ed.language.assistance@ed.gov. Filing a complaint can be quick, easy, and free. You do not need a lawyer to file. We are ready to listen. please contact DOJ or OCR if you have questions. We are here to help.